Pleasure of giving the word to Davide Bionda, Innovation Manager, Merchantship Division of Fincantieri.
Thank you for the opportunity to speak to you how we try to build the first green ship. Is a long travel. So just a very short recap of who we are. So Fincantieri has a 230 year of history. We are present in four continents, and we have about 20,000 people. And we manage for our ship just in Italy over than 7,000 suppliers. We are able to build more or less each type of ship. Now we are concentrating in the naval ship and in the for military application. And in the cruise ship. But we don't forget the other areas like mega yacht or ro-ro ferries and so on. We are also studying the possibility to build something as offshore facilities for energy production, by wind farm or something like this. And last, we are looking also out of maritime market with cooperating in big infrastructure, for example, for the new bridge of Genova, but we are looking also to help the port authorities for electrification and so on. Our clients are speaking of the business cruise, our clients are more or less all the most important clients. Now, coming to our problem. As you said, we have to look far away in the time because the ship has a life of about 25 years. So the ship that we are building today has to be ready already for the 2050. Finally, the MEPC 78 designed the areas for the Mediterranean, and probably the NECA will follow very soon, I hope. And our ship are already prepared for this because we have already designed and built ships that are sailing in the however, we have to look to the future. The IMO has the initial strategy to reduce the greenhouse gas emission to of 50% in the 2050, but we know already that probably this ambition has to be changed. And also the EU decided to reach the climate neutrality in the 2050. So we have to look to this problem in a very different way. Up to today, we study the ship only looking what is happening on board. Now, to reach this type of target, we have to have a holistic approach and to look in a well-to-wake perspective. So we have to look also, which is the greenhouse gas emission of the fuel before to arrive on the ship. What is clear is that we have to change the fuel from the traditional heavy fuel oil, we have to pass to the liquefied natural gas, things that we have already done, also in cooperation with Gasunie, as I said before. But we are looking also to methanol, ammonia, liquid hydrogen. And this is an issue for us because all this fuel has a lower energy density before in respect of the traditional. So, or we have to reduce the autonomy of the ship, or we have to reduce the payload of the ship. Furthermore, there are problems of safety, and because some of these fuel are toxic, some are corrosive, the hydrogen and the natural gas require cryogenic storage, so a lot of problem. that we have to try to solve in some way. There are available a lot of technology to solve some problem, as I said before, scrubber, selective catalytic reduction, and so on. But we are looking also to new engine, new turbogas for the new fuel, with the fuel cell. We are now speaking of a reformer, methanol, CO2 storage, cryogenic storage, and so on. But another aspect that we have to take into account is that the viability of the fuel and also the possible future price that is in any case higher than the traditional fuel. But the real big problem is the availability of the fuel that also for the natural gas that is something technologically solved. The facilities in the port are not so present, so the viability of the fuel is in any case a problem. Making a summarizing the situation, we have technologies with different maturity level. Sometimes need scale up or in any case adaptation for the marine environment. The rules and regulation are not fully defined. There are some rules, but not for all fuel and not for all the situation. The, as I already said, the viability and the cost of the fuel are uncertain. So the problem for our client is that how to plan the investment, which is the right fuel, when I have to pass from a fuel to another, so there is a big risk for them. And furthermore, the supply chain is still not ready. For many technologies, there is not a supply chain. They have not the possibility to make assistance worldwide, and so on. This is clear that we are in front of a breakthrough change, and we need a breakthrough innovation. How we try to pass this situation, this period of transition. We use a cooperative approach with our supplier, and with we have a lot of partnership, more than 50 with the university and research and development centers. And we invest about 150 billion years in research and development. Of course, we have cooperation with our client and with all the classification societies. What we are studying, now we are studying all the application of the most important fuel. Considering already studied the liquid natural gas, we are now looking to methanol, ammonia, the green biofuel, and hydrogen. We are developing an instrument for the simulation dynamic position along all the life of the ship for the calculation of the new coefficient, the ADI, XI, CII, the greenhouse gas intensity, to make the compliance balance, and so on. We are doing feasibility study for the storage system and for the power generation technologies that are also space demanding in respect of the traditional ones. And we are looking also in studies for the feasibility study for the energy supply from ashore. And because the ship are already, normally are already equipped with a short connection, and but the power supply in the port is still very limited. At the end, we are also studying the possibility to of carbon capture system, both in on ground as well on the ship. But in practice, we are doing something different from the past. Normally, we leave the test of the technologies to our supplier. For this new transition, because it's so big the impact on the ship, we prefer to have a direct study and laboratories to test the various technologies. For example, we have two laboratories, one in Savona and one in Trieste, to the test of the proton exchange membrane cell. And we have all the relevant ancillaries. We have a system for hydrogen generation, compression, storage. We have the installed the management system of the power and the automation, and also system with batteries and super capacitor. We are building the first prototype. We have already launched the demo that would be a zero emission boat. It is a boat propeller with 130 kilowatt of fuel cell. The hydrogen is contained in metal hydride. And there is also a system of batteries. We expect that the possibility to sail at zero emission with the speed of 7.5 knots, but is the vessel that we want to use to test all the various alternatives for different fuels. We hope to receive the approval, because it's a problem to receive the approval, because there is not a clear frame regulation for this kind of vessel, but we hope to have the sea trial in this summer. I finished. I thank you for the attention. If you have any question, please don't hesitate.